religion.
See, it would be wrong, therefore, to think that the Apostle John has left the subject of fellowship with God behind.
Yeah.
On the contrary, the subject of knowing God is the logical continuation of what's going on in chapter 1.
Uh-huh.
John's intention is probably not so much to imply the young age of his audience, but rather to express his affection.
Yeah.
Listen to it. Now be ready to sit down. 2 minutes. Watch. Listen to it. We come out of chapter 1 and chapter 2. I'm going to just get on with it. John says, he comes out of that, and he just finished talking about this fellowship, this relationship. And listen to what it says in verse 1. My little children.
Yeah.
That's it.
You all have a smile on your face.
Yeah.
Listen to what it is. After what I just told you, I walked with him, I touched him, I handled him, and I could really put my hand on his breast. And then chapter 2 comes out, my little children.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That is so
tender. Yeah,
yeah. You know how it is? I'm going to end on this point. You know how it is, young folks? You've been on the road, you've been living life for 66 years. You've been pastoring for 26 years. You've been to some places some folks haven't been.
Mm-hmm.
I've been pastoring now 49, thank you for coming up here. We're 49 years, the same church. And you need the young folks, for every generation I'm standing before, you need to know I've been where you are.
Yeah!
That's right, yeah!
Boy, yeah.
But you don't know what it's like to be where I am.
Tell it!
And when John said, little children, yeah. I touched him. Yeah. I handled him up, put my hand on his breast when he was in his body, but now that he's gone, I still got the same touch of little children.
Yeah.
I'm writing to you so you can have the same time of it. Somebody ought to give me more.
Uh-huh.
He's evangelized. He said, my little children.
Yeah.
Yes. He's a mighty man of God, and he speaks from a position of caring. And isn't it amazing? When you pastor people, sometimes you're doing the best to keep them from hitting the wall. It's just God doing it. He's just saying to them, little children, let me tell you, don't go there. If you sin, but don't. He said, no, first of all, he said, don't sin.
That's right. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
need a fellowship to put on a meal. Look, I'm not talking about going there with people.
Yeah.
I'm only talking about this. But yeah. Chapter 1 is talking only about the fellowship with God.
Yeah.
And when you got that fellowship with God, look, see, once the anointing comes in your life, I'm trying to quit. Once the anointing really comes in your life, you got to guard it with your life.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
You can't handle with everybody. Because everybody's not going in your direction.
That's right.
And once you start to grow, once you start to understand how sweet the fellowship is to the Lord, and you begin to grow in your walk with God, and you begin to grow in your best friend, might not want you to be, not to be mad at you, they just don't want you to leave them. If you work with them, partying and getting high, but now you don't want to do that no more. You don't want to gossip anymore. You don't want to hear that everywhere anymore. And they don't want you to not do that. They want to have communion with them. So sometimes you got to leave somebody. Sometimes you got to say, I love you, but I love you more.
Yeah.
My relationship with you is compromised in my relationship with them. I got to make a choice. I want to love you. I'm not against you, but I love you more. And you got to walk away from some people.
Amen.
I'm not finished. I'm not there.